everybody. Drew Schulke. I'm joined today by Jodey Hogeland. And in this today's session, Jodey, we're going to talk about unified storage.
Sounds good.
But before we jump into what actually unified storage is, why don't we kind of talk about the evolution of primary storage, kind of how that's matured over time?
Yeah, historically, Drew, we know a lot of customers have done siloed block-based environments and file-based environments. But over the past few decades, we've seen massive transition towards, you know, these unified storage environments where you've got customers that are running, you know, their traditional block-based workloads, like running Fibre Channel Protocol, iSCSI on the Ethernet side of the house. And those are delivering specific benefits for customers. You know, for example, you know, performance is a key aspect that they're looking for, right? Fibre Channel specifically driving the lowest latency, as well as driving the highest, you know, throughput, right? And so latency and throughput are key when you're talking about delivering, you know, these type of applications that are connected in this methodology. And there is another aspect that customers have historically looked at when it comes to block-based protocols, and that's getting into the resiliency and data mobility aspect. And so they want the ability to have, make sure that they're getting their replication, whether that's asynchronous replication, synchronous replication, active metro environments, right? So a lot of those high performance demands while delivering resiliency and mobility, you know, tend to drive customers in this block-based protocol connectivity methodology. But what we're seeing is while that's still a very huge piece of the market, there's a pretty large transition that's happening towards next gen block connectivity, and that specifically is NVMe over fabrics, and that will be NVMe fiber channel as well as NVMe TCP. Now, NVMe TCP is probably the most popular. It's growing in extreme popularity, because it does drive down cost.
Yeah.
And so customers looking for, hey, I need all of this stuff that I've historically done, but I want to start taking advantage of this high performance, low latency connectivity and next generation methodologies, and that's where that's coming in.
And Ethernet is pretty ubiquitous these days as well, right? So that's helping to play. But I think the key point is all those attributes you talked about of being important over here, performance, mobility, those all carry forward. You don't get a pass on those because this is primary storage.
Yeah, what I did here, I have to do here, right?
Exactly. Yeah. So let's kind of round out with sort of a third bucket here, and we're going to talk about transactional file. Now, file storage means a lot of things, but when we talk about transactional file, we're talking about file storage protocols, and usually we're talking, you know, NFS, SMB, but these are, you know, file-based storage protocols that have these same expectations. I need high performance, very low latency, high throughput. I need all those same mobility options that you talked about, because these are running and supporting applications like, you know, Oracle NFS or VMware NFS. And, you know, again, I don't get to pass on any of these things. And so this whole idea behind unified, as we're trying to get to the punchline of the session here today, is that, you know, because the expectations of what that storage is doing is consistent, even though the protocols might be very different, we want to package this up and deliver it in a way that we're not compromising on any of these elements of the expectation of what the storage must do, but do so in a way that we provide a very consistent experience for the operators of this storage.
Yeah.
Because look, they don't know what sort of hosts are going to connect to that storage long term. It might be some of these workloads, maybe some more kind of SQL database centric stuff, which makes more sense on block. But this idea of unified is, we're not going to constrain you. We're not going to force you to buy one system for this or another system for that. Everything that you get from a performance, mobility, resiliency expectation will be consistent across these, but we're just going to give you choice in terms of that underlying protocol.
Yeah, and as we look at this transition between, you know, let's just say heritage block connectivity methodologies to next generation connectivity block methodologies to transactional file based methodologies, you mentioned examples like Oracle, you know, direct NFS, VMware over NFS, but, you know, Drew, you see this as much as I do. Container connectivity methodology is skyrocketing.
Right.
And a majority of those implementations right now in the industry have been done over NFS.
That's right.
Yeah, so when we're talking about the ability to say, you know, your heritage, you know, traditional block applications, next generation block applications, we even have customers that, you know, have traditionally run VMware NFS that are now saying, hey, VMware has been supporting NVMe TCP since ESXi 7 update 3. We were co-design partners in that regard and said, hey, you know, as a result, I'm going to take those VMware workloads, transition them to NVMe TCP, but then I still might have a lot of these containers that are popping up on me that I need NFS connectivity for.
Yeah.
So I think, you know, PowerStore working to deliver that solution to say, you know what, you know, regardless of whether it's, you know, your traditional way of doing block or it's the next gen way of doing block or you want that high performance transactional file capability for next generation applications, et cetera, PowerStore is a good answer.
Yeah, no compromise on performance, no compromise on mobility, simplified usage, and future-proofed in terms of where those workloads may go in the future.
Yeah.
That's a pretty powerful story for unified storage.
It is an incredible story. And the fact that, you know, you drew this box around the entirety of the ecosystem, and just imagine that being a single storage pool where regardless if it's heritage block, next gen block, transactional file, it's all part of the reducibility in a global profile. So PowerStore's efficiency plays very strong here.
Yeah. So, hey everybody, I hope you enjoyed this topic today on unified storage. We'll talk to you soon.